Hey guys, how's it? Aloha, this is Jeeps here, your old composer here at the Decomposer Lounge, pulling back the layers that you suggest, and I am on to number 22 on my countdown, 30 to 1, 1 being my 1 year anniversary on November 18th, and I am going to be doing, by mass suggestion, this particular track. The band name, I've only done one before, so I'm probably going to get it wrong because I didn't master the name. Viljarta? Please remember, forgive me, I'm old and not saturated in the genres to know the names. This track is called Vagabond, so I want to thank those of you who are actually watching that one video on the cover of my channel. That's how you get your submissions to me, just for this countdown of 30 days where I'm recycling through all the bands that are on this channel that you guys bring up based on you leaving comments on those videos. Makes my life easier to figure out which ones to do up until my big 1 year anniversary where I've got something special planned. Anyhow, so let's do this. You guys know the story. These videos do not monetize this channel. So if you want to buy me a cup of coffee, you know where the link is. The link is down below for the headsets. The link is going to be down below for their song Vagabond. That'll also be below. And also for my Patreon just as well. You can check that out. So let's do this. Viljarta, Vagabond. All right.
Försvinner in i mörkret och den grå massan ser bak. Köken domnar mitt medvetande. Under tak och stunder är jag fri. Är jag fri?
Wow, that was absolutely menacing. If there's any other better way to put that, I don't know how to say it. And what I mean by the menacing aspect of it, not because it's the darker, heavier side of metal and stuff that I'm slowly getting more of a handle on as I learn. It's been a year on this channel almost, and I'm still learning, and that's what I love about this process. I'm still learning, you guys are teaching me. And especially now that I'm listening to newer songs of some of these super heavier bands with this, you know, more forward technical aspect and engineering and tones and stuff like that. Anyhow, let me get back to the menacing thing. That opening guitar pattern, that clean sound, that disturbing kind of pattern in the notes, these like semitone kind of vibes that are going in there that kind of, it just pulls and bends you kind of in a very dark, heavy kind of way. But, you know, using the clean sound, but then they slowed that down. And I knew I was in for something because this was the band I remember now that gave me, you know, I had to get a defibrillator because it scared the shit out of me. And it did it again because I had the volume up a little bit listening for that cleaner tone, and then they hit with all that power. The pattern, the riff that they're playing, once again, this following suit of that dark, menacing kind of, I just like walk down these semitone kind of vibes that are heavy. But what I really kind of glammed onto for a second is the opening, especially the vocal, you know, the lead growling, you know, power part of what he's saying. Actually, in the same, in unison of the guitar part, actually added a tone to that growl where I saw, oh, that is really super cool. You know, even though I know that it's just a powerful growl and that he's doing and everything, because he was in direct unison with the guitar and the way it was mixed, it kind of fit. It kind of slid into a little bit of that tonal vibe. It felt that, so you know. Anyhow, I'm just going to keep going. It's just very dark, very heavy, and what I love, but as I'm starting to get into tones of guitars because I'm learning, because I want to try my very first own little seven-string djenty thing that I've tried, these tones are to behold, you know. I did the noob mistake, you know, trying all the gain and stuff and realizing, well, that's not the trick. But I'm learning, and these tones are incredible. Anyhow, let's march on a bit. Stand by. You know, as dark and as heavy as this is, these intricate parts that are going on behind are what really are pulling me through as I'm going through this, you know, with my ears. What I mean by that is, through this passage, this section that I just stopped in, and maybe about 30 bars ago, what seems to be like these haunting voices in the background, well, what I can't figure out, because I can hear the fact that clean guitar that was opened up the song is still present in the mix. And it's holding down these longer ambient notes that are kind of, they really cut through cleanly for me as an arrangement and a layered composition in adjacent to the powerful, you know, crunch guitars that are just wailing away on the riff. But I'm hearing that, but then, like, at this passage here, I'm hearing what seems like vocal, you know, half notes, you know, some whole notes and stuff that are holding these really long, those half or whole notes, but are very ominous. And they actually add, like, a second depth to what's already dark and menacing to this, you know, composition. And I don't know what the guitars are tuned to, but I think this was the band that I made reference to, that they must be tuned in drop balls, because that's where I can kind of feel it. It's like, it's so powerful, it's so heavy. And I don't know what the lyrics are, and you know, you have to look at them and stuff, but just the whole performance seems to just pull from the bowels of spirituality, if there's such a way to say that, you know, in the darkest, heaviest sense of raw, you know, kind of a thing. And it's pretty intense. Can we go back a little bit? You know, this is what I love lately. The last couple songs that I have listened to have tailed off with a piece of their arrangement that made it really easy for me to kind of sit there and go, have a moment and go, oh, okay, I get what they did there. First of all, let's talk about that arpeggiation that they played with the time digital delay. As soon as I got back into that, you know, you heard it all bouncing around that really clean guitar. Great use. I love when bands and engineers stretch the experience by doing stuff like that. And in that section, it was wonderfully played out in the sense that that guitar was the only thing that was happening. By adding that left to right timed delay really made a difference. For those of you who don't know anything about how its music is done, and in this case, you're the pure listener, which I wish I could be. A pinged time delay left to right would be something that would be set in tempo of the song. So if I went like this, it wouldn't go da da da. It would go actually in the timing of da 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 of the track itself, and then you can tweak that to actually play on itself, based on feedback and even tweaking it to, you know, maybe a triplet or something like that. Super trick. And then they gave us about another 18 bars of this, what I'm just using that word again, very menacing, heavy, like blade saw synth sounding kind of vibe on top of that, you know. And I was waiting for it. You could see me just kind of like going, it's going to come again, something's going to hit me. And this time around, though, they grew to that. After about 45 seconds of having both those elements work off of each other, they actually, you know, as you can tell, they grew into when they let the drums and the guitar back in at full power. But even that was so dark and haunting in the tones, and there's so much layering. I've learned recently in my research on how to, you know, these bands and many different bands of genres, how do they get their sounds, because I want to learn how to do it, and realizing that not only will they like double left, right kind of vibe, but they'll even quad record to make this like a huge wash of sound and stuff. But in this case, it is so dark, it is so heavy, and then the way they just wound it out too. And in it, it does sound like behind there, especially when we just heard this little tail end, they kind of brought back up that really dark, you know, kind of saw, kind of harsh digital vibe back up into the mix with that. Because I was going, how are they getting that sound in there? And then as the song fades, they let that ride out there. I went, ah, that's what they did. And that's production. The guy's sitting in a room going, how do we want to end this? The engineer, you know, that's you know how I always say the engineer is part of the band sometimes. I'm going to say most of the times when it comes to releasing an album and stuff, especially something as technical as this and all the stuff that I've been learning about prog rock, metalcore, thrash metal, and all the subgenres, it just goes on and on for me. Anyhow, so this was number 22 on my countdown. Thank all of you that did suggest Vagabond to me. That was the name of the song, and the band is Viljarta. And, you know, I'm sorry if I got it wrong. Still got plenty more to go. If you want to suggest a band that I've already done here on this, you know, 30-day countdown, you just go to the front page of my YouTube channel. There's a little video there. Just watch that for about a minute. I give you little quick instructions because it's easier for me to, excuse me, figure it out this way and do the best I can to hopefully choose your song for this countdown until November 18th. And I'm going to take a bit of a break. But that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. You guys take care of yourself. I'll see you tomorrow for number 21. All right. Aloha. Yahoo! All right.